Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craftroom, and in this video I'm going to use Nuvo Pure Sheen Glitter to create fun backgrounds. I share a bunch of different ways to use glitter, make it less messy and use adhesive film only with the glitter to create some fun sparkling cards. Here are the things I'm going to use. A big coffee filter, the glitter doesn't stick to the paper like it does to regular printing paper. I have an anti-static cloth to wipe off excess glitter. I have the Tonic Studios paper creaser and the Precision Glide, they will both work. And I have the Nuvo Surface Sweep. And I will tell more about it in the video. I have a square die, this one is a double edge, but you can use a regular square die too. And I'm going to use every other die from the set. And I use masking tape to hold them in place. I take a piece of paper, the sticky side up, and I add the dies, lining them up at an even space in between. And then I'm going to add the dies on a piece of backing of double-sided adhesive. Never throw that away. And I put it at an angle through the machine with the corner going first. This is the easiest way for the machine to get it through, and it's easier to roll it through also. I have a piece of double-sided adhesive on ultra smooth card and I burnish it with a precision glide. I take off the backing and I keep that, and now I'm going to add the open squares. Just add them, you don't have to press them down. Just so you know, I added the main products I used in the description box for you. You can find the full list of supplies on my blog, and if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. And when you do so, you may like to click the little notification bell so you don't miss a thing. And then I add the backing with the slippery side on the card and burnish again. This way the squares stick to the card really well. I take off the backing again and I put the card in the coffee filter. And I'm going to add the first color of glitter. And then I shake the glitter back in the pot, make sort of a funnel to guide it back, and you can see the filter is clean. I spilled a bit on my desk and I use the anti-static cloth to wipe it off. And now I'm going to burnish the glitter on the card. You can do this later also after removing the paper backing. I take the surface sweep to remove the glitter from the paper. This way you can use it again. If you don't want to use the paper again, you can skip this step. And then I take off the squares. Here I use the craft pick so I don't have to bend the card. And then I add the next color. I'm going to burnish again so the glitter sticks really well on the card, and I also use the surface sweep to remove any excess. I also tried it with just a surface sweep and then hardly any glitter comes off. And this brush is really great for this. I was at an event and I let people test it and they were also amazed how well this brush removed any excess glitter. And here's the first background. I use the squares again for the next card, but I'm making another pattern. And this is kind of fun, just adding the pieces a bit like making a puzzle. And I add them partly over each other this time. Now don't forget to burnish with the backing piece you removed. And then I add the first color glitter. And I burnish and remove it with a surface sweep again. Now I only remove a few of the squares. And I add another color. I changed my plan in the meantime. I did the same steps again, and then I'm going to add the third color. For the third card, I'm going to use the squares again to make another pattern, diagonal this time, and you see with the clean paper you can use it over and over. I wipe off the excess glitter with the surface sweep again. And the surface sweep is really a great tool. I didn't expect that it would be so great for this, but it really is. I'm super excited about it, and I wish I could let you feel it, but I can't, which is a bit of a bummer. So I burnished again, and I also used the anti-static cloth to clean the precision glide, and I take off the squares to add the second color. And this is the finished background, the last pattern with the squares. It's fun to use them over and over and make all sorts of patterns. Just be creative and add them randomly. I didn't film adding the chocolate glitter, but you get the idea, and I will show all the cards at the end of the video. I cut circles out of a piece of backing from the double-sided adhesive, and I have double-sided adhesive on a piece of card. I add the backing on the piece, and then I'm going to burnish. I added some more circles and burnished again, and then I'm going to add the first color glitter. I rub it in a bit with my finger this time, and I'm going to wipe off the glitter so I can use the piece with the circles cut out again. I take off the piece, and then I'm going to add the second color. I burnished and cleaned with the sweep, and another background is done. Another pattern with the circles. I use open and complete circles this time, and I add them randomly on the card again. And I add the glitter in the same way. I did not burnish the glitter this time, and now I'm going to add the second color, and this will stick in the places where the first color did not stick, and it's really visible because the second color is darker than the first one. Now I burnish and then shake off and sweep again. And here you can see the fun color mix. I remove the paper pieces, and I use the craft spoon to add bits of glitter on the circles. And then I shake off the excess by flipping the page in one turn, and then I'm going to add the next color to fill the sticky spots. And another background is done. And now the last technique with the double-sided adhesive sheets. I added it to a card again and I'm going to tear off a piece of the backing. And then I'm going to add one color. I don't put the glitter back in the jar, I just take another coffee filter for the next color. I tear off another piece and add the next color, and I have a new filter for each color and I keep tearing and adding glitter until I colored the complete card. And you can do this with any color mix, a fun Christmas color scheme or fall or any other season. And while you are here, have you seen the community tab at the top? Available on smartphone and desktop. I will share new and fun things there, like behind the scenes, sneak peeks, polls and such. So you can check that out if you like. And maybe you want to go all glitter crazy for your Christmas cards. And when you want to make your cards in bulk, add the coffee filters next to each other and go from one color to the next. So you don't have to add the glitter back each time. So here's the finished background. I turned all the backgrounds into cards and I used the Tim Holtz Shadow Script dies for sentiments for the first three cards. For the next cards, I added stone drops in two colors and crystal drops on the gold pink card. For the sentiments, I cut the words with the new Tim Holtz alphabet die. I cut them out of grey board and colored cardstock for extra dimension. And for the next card, I used the same alphabet for the sentiments. And I used crystal drops on one card and the Tim Holtz side order to cut the frames for both cards. Now, that was quite a lot. I hope this video was helpful and sparked your ideas to get glittery yourself. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting.